Today, you're going to learn the top trends that are changing education forever. These are huge trends that we found early by analyzing millions of signals across the internet and boiling down all of this research into one video. I'm going to show you the overarching trends, the specific software and AI tools that you can start using today, and overall what this means for the future of education. So if you want to see all the latest trends on tech, AI, make sure you hit subscribe and let's dive in. Students now have access to coaching 24/7, and it adapts to how they learn. These AI-powered learning platforms and virtual tutors are designed to identify when somebody gets stuck, adjust how hard it is, and then guide them through the process step by step. Now, on the academic side, Khan Academy's Khanmigo walks students through math problems by asking guided questions instead of giving shortcuts. And Google Lens lets you snap a photo of a tricky homework question, then breaks it down into plain steps so you can see how the answer is built. Language learning is also being completely reshaped. Duolingo Max uses AI for conversation practice and then explains why your answers were wrong. Tools like TalkPal can stimulate live conversations with instant pronunciation feedback, while LanguaTalk pairs human sessions with AI drills so learners can keep practicing between calls. These platforms cover everything from math and science to languages. Tools like Memrise's Pronunciation Buddy give learners personalized speaking feedback and cultural context so practice feels natural and safe. For students, that means they build confidence faster. For teachers, it reduces the need to repeat the same drills over and over. Now, about 12,100 people search for AI tutors every single month, and that number of searches has grown 247%, and is definitely set to keep growing. That tells us that thousands and thousands of parents and students are actively searching for these solutions. For sellers, online marketers, people who are looking to build AI platforms, this means the market is explosive. Language learning platforms are a significant part of this trend. TalkPal is now pulling in around 18,000 monthly searches, and that interest is exploding more than 8,000% since launch. That's tens of thousands of learners actively seeking AI conversation practice every single month. LanguaTalk is right behind, with nearly 15,000 monthly searches, and the number of people searching is growing over 1,000%. Together, these signals, they show us that language learners do not just want flashcards. They want something interactive, something guided, that feels like a real conversation. So, who is this for, and how can it help you directly? Well, if you're a high school student or teacher, you can snap tonight's algebra question in Google Lens and get the exact step you're missing, then find similar math problems to practice and lock it in. If you're learning a new language during your commute, you can run a 10-minute conversation that corrects your phrasing on the spot. It's like having a personal language coach in your pocket, ready whenever you are. If you're a teacher, tools like Khanmigo already help you shoulder your load. It can generate differentiated lesson plans, quizzes, exit tickets, so that you're not manually building everything from scratch. Teachers report it frees up time to mentor, to lead projects, and give more one-on-one support. So if you're a parent watching your kid struggle with a math problem at 9 p.m., this is like having a professional tutor on standby whenever you need it. Personally, I don't have kids, but if my cat is ever struggling to solve an algebra problem, I'll know where to go. For example, students who were in pilot programs using Khanmigo saw fewer failing grades in tough classes because the AI caught gaps early and offered step-by-step hints when the student got stuck. And if you're building education products or looking to invest in them, this is what people are demanding. In other words, this is what's coming next. Non-static content, but step-by-step, interactive, adaptive flows. Research in digital learning shows that personalized feedback tailored to where the student is stuck is strongly correlated with better outcomes. The next wave of AI learning tools will adjust in real time, they're going to help teachers scale, and make sure everybody with an internet connection has the support and the tools to learn the way they learn. So clearly this software is changing the game, reinventing what education actually means. Now let's look at physical products. Physical devices are solving problems that software can't, like live translation in multilingual classrooms, instant text scanning for super dense textbooks, and even interactive robots that turn learning into play. So let's look at AI gadgets and tools that are transforming education. In Texas, schools are already piloting the Timekettle X1. A teacher speaks English, and within 2 seconds, a Spanish-speaking student hears the same lesson in their own language through earbuds. It means that new arrivals don't sit silent for weeks. They're part of the class from day one. And students can bring parents into conferences without scrambling for a separate interpreter. The iFlyTech Smart Dictionary Pen solves another daily classroom problem. A student can scan a dense biography paragraph, and within seconds, they get the definition, translation, and even audio pronunciation of tricky terms without stopping the entire lesson. For multilingual or exam-heavy environments, that speed makes a huge difference. Then there are these AI-powered toys like Loona, Miko 3, and Cozmo 2.0. These are robots that recognize voices, answer questions, and adapt their responses based on a child's interest. So if your kid loves space, then the robot can incorporate space facts into math problems, making learning engaging and personalized. Beyond that, tools like Lego Mindstorms and Sphero Bolt teach coding and problem solving through hands-on building and programming, turning difficult STEM concepts into fun, interactive games. About 4,400 people are searching for AI toy every single month, and that interest has grown roughly 1,400% over recent years. That is an exponentially increasing amount of people who are searching for these gadgets. AI Kids Robot has grown about 367% in searches, with steady monthly sales and broad listing activity. Now, what that tells us as trend experts is that this section of the market is growing super quickly. Imagine being able to create or market the very first version of ChatGPT. That's what we're seeing here. If you're a teacher, listen up, because this benefit is huge for you. Instead of repeating the same instructions or waiting on a translation support, you can spend more one-on-one time mentoring students. If you're a parent, this is going to make your life a lot easier because you don't have to remember everything. You're just there to assist your kid and help them through the process. 5 or 10 minutes with a robot like Miko or Loona can spark curiosity without screens hijacking the whole evening. Kids often end up asking for more practice because it feels like fun, not homework. And if you're on the business side, whether that's selling, building, creating content, the products that win are the ones that solve a very specific classroom problem and are dead simple to use. Teachers don't have time to tinker with a complicated setup or try and learn an AI platform that's complex from scratch. So making it user-friendly is a huge trust builder, and that's what's going to determine the tools that actually get used. If you're a creator or a brand or you're marketing these products, make sure that you're thinking about capturing that aha moment. Show a student scanning a textbook line and getting the meaning instantly. Or film a robot tailoring math practice around a kid's love for space. These short clips do more to sell or market these products than any data will. Now, in the next section, I want to zoom out and I want to look ahead so you can see what's coming next. AI is widening access and shifting roles. A multilingual classroom can receive new arrivals that get interacted with and learn from day one. Teachers are moving time from drafting and grading into small group work and mentoring. So adoption of all of this tech is not coming from one group. It's students, teachers, entire schools, parents, all moving in the same direction. In fact, over 8,000 people search for AI for teachers every single month, and that number has grown roughly 118% in recent years. That's thousands of educators that are actively looking for help creating lesson plans, grading, and future planning. Magic School helps teachers generate lesson plans, quizzes, and differentiated practice in seconds. And that's why it's seeing around 300,000 searches every single month, with a growth of those searches around 8,700%. The company recently raised $45 million in Series B funding, bringing its total to $62.4 million, and now it employs more than 100 people. If the numbers weren't enough, then all of that funding should tell you that this is where the industry is heading. There are going to be a dime a dozen for these kinds of tools. So, early adoption and making noise about these tools is key. Squirrel AI is an adaptive learning system for K-12. It continuously checks where students are struggling and it adjusts the material in real time. With a growth in searches from about 3,600%, there are 500 plus employees and roughly $190.3 million raised. It's one of the clearest examples of AI tutoring scaling up to serve millions of students. Now, Delphi AI creates digital clones of subject matter experts, allowing employees to practice, ask questions, receive guidance as if they were learning directly from a human coach. About 5,400 people are searching for this every month, and that number of people is growing about 1,000%, and it's raised already $18.7 million. Companies and investors are actively looking to invest and scale these platforms. It is the next wave. So let's get specific about what this means for your world. First, if you're a teacher or you're running a school, these tools can handle all the time-consuming stuff. Lesson drafts, creating different versions for different skill levels, basic feedback on assignments. It frees up hours for the work that actually matters. So the key to getting parents and staff on board? Be upfront about privacy and keep the user guidelines simple. If you're a parent, you can think of this as the backup that's always available. If your kid gets stuck on homework at 8 p.m., the AI tutor can explain everything in plain English and lets them try again without making them feel bad about getting it wrong the first time around. Now, if you're building or selling education products, you're looking at two different buyers. It's going to be school districts with procurement processes and parents buying directly. The products that win package everything together: content, tools, tutoring, and they promise specific results that you can measure. So here's what's coming in 2026. Tutors are not just going to chat with you. They're going to see what you're doing. So picture this. You're working on a physics exam. You point your phone at your work, and the AI spots exactly where you made the mistake and shows you how to fix it. Content is going to be generated on the fly. So instead of generic study guides, you'll get quizzes and explanations built specifically for what you don't understand yet for you and the way that you actually learn. Virtual field trips and lab simulations are going to adapt how fast you learn. If you're getting things quickly, the AI will add complexity so people can learn at their own pace. If you need more time, it slows down and gives you other examples. Imagine a neurodivergent kid who has trouble reading instructions and retaining the information, but learns more visually or actively. These tutors can automatically create lessons out of thin air that are specifically guided for that person because it knows about their neurodivergence and the research behind how those kids learn best. It knows all of that already, so it can just create a lesson plan for them right there. For working adults, learning paths will connect directly to job outcomes. So think from customer support to account manager in 60 days, with simulations and feedback that mirror real work situations. Privacy controls will make or break these deals. Schools and parents are going to choose vendors who explain their data practices clearly and make opting out very simple. There is a lot more to go through in the education sector, but I hope this overview gave you an idea of what's coming to the space in 2026. Learning is not going to be the same, at least not for anybody with an internet connection. The way that people use these tools, adapt them, and leverage them is going to determine the next generation's ability to learn, information retention, everything. The importance of these tools and this industry cannot be understated. It is the future. So if you want more trends around education, specific tools for different use cases, drop them in the comments below. I'll search through our database and see if I can find something just for you. Thank you so much for watching. I always appreciate it. If you like this video at all or you found it useful, consider hitting subscribe. That means the world. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next video.